Today, I want to reveal a 3,000-year-old secret. A secret that will lift any nation and its people to the greatest levels of riches and wealth the world has ever known. Political leaders have waged wars. They have even starved their own people to guard this secret. When I reveal this secret to America, we will all rise to a great and wealthy new world. As the title of our TVP platform says, make all the people rich, including the poor. In order to open our flight into riches, we must close our fall into poverty. The rule of man is responsible for poverty on earth, around the world, and throughout history. Countries with the most oppressive rule of man were the poorest, most oppressed countries that led themselves into inescapable suppression and tyranny. To rid the rule of man, we must remove the fundamental ingredient that nourishes the rule of man. And that fundamental ingredient is initiatory force. You see, a ruling class must force its population into obeying the political leaders, obeying their man-made laws, their man-made regulations. And without force, there would be no ruling class, there would be no rule of man. Yet one may ask, how can government lead a nation, lead its people, without the power of force? Let's take a moment here and let's look closely at the concepts of lead and force. Government should lead a nation, should lead its people by force if necessary to protect its people from those initiating force against them or threatening force against them. The government should use force when necessary to protect its people, self-defense force. Now, in my writings, I talk about the one valid purpose of government. That one valid purpose is protecting its people, protecting the people from those violating them, initiating force against them. When government moves beyond that one valid purpose of protecting the people and begins pushing its agenda on the populace, whether that be from the left, the liberal left, or from the conservative right, it makes no difference because they're surpassing the one and only proper purpose of government, and that's to protect the people. At that point, no matter how right they believe in what they're doing, no matter how good their intentions may be, nevertheless, they're pushing their agenda on the people. The only way to have the people obey those man-made laws and regulations is through initiatory force. So when government expands beyond the parameters of protecting us from those initiating force against us or threatening force against us, when the government progresses beyond that purpose And it doesn't matter if it's the left or the right or any in between. When government, when politicians, when regulatory bureaucrats progress beyond the one valid purpose of protecting us, then they enter the parameter of initiatory force. They must have initiatory force. They must have consequences that if certain segments of the population do not obey the law, the man-made laws and regulations, there must be consequences. Consequences are in force, through force, initiatory force, through monetary fines, and ultimately through prison. When the government moves beyond its valid purpose and goes into the next level, the next parameter of initiatory force, that's when the rule of man takes over. All civilizations throughout history have inherently had the rule of man in the governing body. It's been permitted, it's been allowed. Even in our great America, the rule of man is inherent within our ruling body, our governing body. So I must say that all nations throughout all history, all civilizations, have been in one dimension, all in the same dimension. When people say or ask me if my purpose is to bring, with the 12 Visions Party, if my purpose is to bring America back to the founding principles, the forefathers' idea, concept, my answer is no. Not at all. Because even America, early America, still was in that dimension. That dimension where initiatory force was inherent in the governing body. As great as the checks and balances were, as nearly flawless as they were, and as great as the divisions of power were, still, we had man creating the law. We had man interpreting the law. We had man enforcing the law. Man was ultimately in charge, despite the beautiful obstacles that were set in place in our Constitution to prevent, to limit rule of man. Eventually, like a resurging disease, man will adapt. Man will evolve, mutate. Eventually, the disease of the rule of man will rise again, as it has in America, to take over our once great freedoms. The rule of man is in charge once again. And why is that? Because no political structure, no nation, no civilization has ever been established in another dimension, a dimension in which initiatory force is not permitted in the governing body. Initiatory force is prohibited, is eradicated from civilization, including and especially in the governing body. Now that is an entirely new dimension that the world has never known. And in that dimension, as I describe and articulate throughout my writings, there'll be prosperity and wealth, the likes of which the world has never seen before. To go into that next dimension requires the prime law. Without the prime law, that next dimension would not exist. People come to me and make comparisons, attempt to make comparisons between, say, the Libertarian Party to the 12 Visions Party or the Constitution Party. And really, the comparison does not hold. It's true, Libertarian Party moves in our direction. However, the Libertarian Party is still in the only dimension ever known to man, and that's the dimension in which initiatory force is inherent in the governing body. None of these political movements could move into the next dimension, into this new dimension, without the prime law. In fact, the prime law is the 3,000-year-old secret that would lift any nation and its people to great wealth and riches. Now, with that, I'd like to read the prime law with that background once again, so you can see it in a new light. So here we go, the prime law. The prime law, the fundamental of protection. Preamble. The purpose of human life is to prosper and live happily. The function of government is to provide the conditions that let individuals fulfill that purpose. The prime law guarantees those conditions by forbidding the use of initiatory force, fraud, or coercion by any person or group against any individual, property, or contract. Article 1. No person, group of persons, or government shall initiate force, threat of force, or fraud against any individual self, property, or contract. Article 2. Force is morally and legally justified only for protection from those who violate Article 1. Article 3. No exception shall exist for Articles 1 and 2. Now, do you feel and see the prime law in a different light? The prime law is the 3,000-year-old secret that will lift any nation and its people to levels of wealth and riches the world has never seen. And why? Because the prime law prohibits, eradicates initiatory force from our governing body. Initiatory force, that ingredient that nourishes the rule of man, and the rule of man is a cause for poverty. The prime law, the 3,000-year-old secret. Thank you all. And before I part, let me just add that I believe everyone here understands the problem with the rule of man. Flaw-filled, imperfect man driven by ego, power, easily corrupted, often ignorant, fooled easily. It's human nature in this anti-civilization to pursue selfish agendas at the cost of others, and just the desire to control others when given the power. The rule of man is society's disease. And the only way to eradicate the rule of man is through the prime law.